This is Atlas Launch Control, 1 hour, 50 minutes, 47 seconds into the mission of the TDRS-L. And joining us now here on console is Tim Dunn, who was our NASA Launch Director to this flight and the NASA Launch Manager during the countdown. And Tim, I wonder, first of all, give us a snapshot of how this looks like it's all turned out.
Well, thanks, George. Thanks for having me. And you showed some shots in the launch control room, and we're all thrilled. Successful spacecraft separation, and most importantly, a successful spacecraft acquisition by our ground telemetry. So we've confirmed that we've got a healthy spacecraft so far. So the launch team is thrilled, and as you can imagine, the TDRS-L spacecraft team is even more thrilled.
Well, take us back to the beginning of the count, and how did the countdown go, and then how did the flight look?
Well, it was just gorgeous weather on the Space Coast today, so it would have been a shame not to have gotten a launch off today. So we were blessed with tremendous weather. We have a wonderful rocket. We did not work any hardware anomalies on the Atlas V launch vehicle. Our spacecraft, the TDRS-L spacecraft, was rock solid, had zero problems with that. We were working, as we came into the count today, one lingering concern that popped up on the range yesterday with one range instrumentation site, and that being a radar that is needed to track the rocket as it flies out over the Atlantic. So the range team worked overnight and all through today to get us ready to enter countdown, and was able to bring that asset back online during the count for us to have and enable us to launch today.
And any further background on the short recycle that we had?
Oh yeah, that we get through the radar issue that we had. We had a nominal vehicle. Everything looked great. We're about ready to enter that final terminal count at T-4 and counting. And we began to notice about a minute prior to that we were getting a little bit of noisy data coming back from our open-loop spacecraft telemetry at the time. And turns out we were getting a few spacecraft dropouts. The spacecraft team needed a little bit more time. We decided to remain in the T-minus 4-minute hold till we better understood that. Turned out it was a situation with multipathing with the open loop RF transmissions between the antenna located at TEL-4 and the Atlas V vehicle. And so once that situation was well understood, we discuss that on our anomaly net per our process, and we decided that we would, instead of staying open loop for the next attempt, we would stay on our ground line telemetry, a hard line. Obviously that was very clean data, and we made the switch to the open loop RF at T0 or at liftoff. So that was a great plan that the team came up with, and we executed that plan and got back in to the countdown, established a new T0 at 33 minutes past the hour, and were able to execute that and had a beautiful liftoff.
Well, Tim, this is just the start of a very busy year for Launch Services Program, so outline some of the missions we've got still coming up. I know Vern mentioned some of them, but it's we've got a lot of missions coming.
Well, it is an exciting year for Launch Services Program, this being our first. We look to go to the West Coast for a couple of Delta II missions this year. We have the OCO-2 mission that's going to launch on a Delta II from Vandenberg Air Force Base, Space Launch Complex 2. That happens this summer in July. And then in the fall, in November, we go back out to Vandenberg for another Delta II mission, the SMAP mission. And so we're excited to launch on Delta II again. It'll be about 2.5 years since our last Delta II launch. We also have another Atlas V mission that's currently manifested for later in the year, the MMS mission on the East Coast. So we've got a full slate of science missions ahead of us. And everyone in LSP is just thrilled with the TDRS-L launch today.
Well, Tim, thanks very much. And this has certainly been a happy moment for the TDRS team, because they're now 100% on the two they've got now on orbit for for their program, and maybe another one coming downstream a ways, but the two that they wanted right now, they've got right now.
Very good. And if I could, George, I know you mentioned it during the countdown, but this launch was dedicated to Skip Mackey, Memorial Launch. Skip was a dear friend and colleague of ours at NASA, and he was the voice of NASA commentary for years and years. So for Skip's family and his friends and all of his colleagues at NASA, we were very proud, along with ULA, to dedicate this launch, this successful launch of TDRS-L, to Skip.
Well, it's very appropriate that it was a tracking and data relay satellite.
Absolutely.
Which is the kind of thing that you know, was part of what he did, was
yes,
tracking and data. So. Well, in that event, I think we're pretty much we're going to wrap up our launch and flight commentary here. We've had a very successful mission. TDRS-L is on its own. We're in contact with it on the ground. And by all accounts, this has been a very successful launch and a flight today. So, Tim, thanks very much, and we'll see you at Vandenberg.
Sounds good, George.
And we're at 1 hour, 56 minutes, 50 seconds into the flight of TDRS-L. This is Atlas Launch Control.